Assalamu alaikum. Welcome to this MATLAB tutorial. In this tutorial, I am going to teach you how to model a long transmission line in MATLAB Simulink software. For this purpose, I have taken an example from the book Power System Analysis by Hadi Sadat, Chapter 5, Example 5.5. According to this example, a 3-phase 60 Hz 500 kV transmission line is 300 km long. The line inductance is 0.97 mH per km per phase and its capacitance is 0.0115 microfarad per km per phase. Assume a lossless line. The receiving end rated load is 800 MW, 0.8 power factor lagging at 500 kV. We are going to determine the sending end as well as receiving end voltage, current, active, reactive and apparent power. Furthermore, we will also determine the percentage voltage regulation as well as efficiency of the transmission line. The mathematical solution of this example can be found in the Hadi Sadat book. For your convenience, I have uploaded the example solution in the form of PDF link in the description section. You can download it from there. Now I am going to model the long transmission line in MATLAB Simulink software. For this purpose, double click on this Simulink icon to open it. In this window, click on this icon to open a new model. First, we need to save it. You may save it with any name of your choice and in any folder. To design the long transmission line model, first we need a grid or 3-phase voltage source. To get this, go to Simulink library and go to Simscape, then click on Power System, then click on Specialized Technology, then click on Fundamental Blocks and then on Electrical Sources. You can see here 3-phase source block is available. Now right click on this block and click on add block to the model. It will appear in the model. Now double click on it. A window will open. We have to put the values. As we know that this 3-phase source is working as grid station or generator at the sending end station. Therefore here it asks phase to phase RMS voltage, which is sending end line voltage in this case. The sending end line voltage as calculated is 617.53 kV with 16.1 degree as shown here. Therefore, write 617.53 kV here and write phase angle to 16.1 degree here. Now it asks about the frequency. As the given frequency in the example data is 60 Hz as shown here, therefore put 60 Hz here. As we are not going to perform short circuit analysis, therefore uncheck this internal resistance icon. Click on the load flow and if it is swing, then keep it same, otherwise change it to swing and click on OK. Now we have to measure the sending end voltage and current. Therefore, we need 3-phase measurement block which is available here. Bring it to the model. It will appear here. Connect it with the 3-phase source. Just click here and delete this 3-phase measurement and write sending end voltage and current here. Now double click on it. A window will open. It shows that voltage measurement is phase to ground. Keep it same. And it asks about current measurement. As we also want to calculate the current, so keep it yes and click OK. Now we need long transmission line. For this purpose, this distributed parameters line block can be used to represent the long transmission line. Bring it to the model and connect it. Now double click on it, a window will open. Is our system consist of 3 phase and 60 Hz frequency? Therefore, keep this 3 and 60 Hz as it is. The resistance in the given example is 0. Therefore, write 0 2 times here. The inductance given in the example data is 0.97 mH per kilometer as shown here. Therefore, write here 0.97 mH here. Furthermore, it may be noted that here you must write 0.99 mH. It is necessary to get the correct results. Otherwise, it gives error. However, this setting is valid for this example only. Now, the capacitance given in the example data is 11.5 nanofarad per kilometer. Therefore, write here 11.5 nanofarad 2 times. We know that the length of the transmission line is 300 km as shown here. Therefore, write 300 here and press OK. Now, we again need 3-phase measurement block to measure voltage and current at the receiving end station. Therefore, copy this block by right-clicking on it and then paste it where you want and connect it with the transmission line. Change the name to receiving end voltage and current. Now, we need 3-phase load block to put the load values. For this purpose, bring this 3-phase series RLC load block from here in the model. You can rotate it by pressing Ctrl plus R to change its direction in order to connect it with other components. Now double click on it, a window will open. We have to put the values for receiving end voltage, frequency and other parameters of the load. The receiving end voltage is 500 kV and frequency is 60 Hz as shown here in the example data. Therefore, write here 500 kV and frequency as 60 Hz. The receiving end active and reactive power of the load is given as 800 MW and 600 MVAR as shown here in the example data. Therefore, write here 800 and here 600. And put capacitive reactive power to 0, because our load is inductive. Now we need to connect the measurement block to display so that voltage and current measurements can be seen. Before this, it may be noted that meters usually measure RMS voltage. Take this RMS block from here and bring it in the model. Connect it with the 3-phase measurement block. Double click on this RMS block, change the initial RMS value to 0 and press OK. Now bring the display block from here into the model. Connect this display block with the RMS block in order to measure the voltage. Change the name from display to sending end voltage. For current measurement, just copy the RMS block and display block by pressing Ctrl plus C and pasting it here by pressing Ctrl plus V. Now connect this with the current measurement port. Change the name of the display block to sending end current. Now I think we can run the simulation to see the measurement on sending end side. Before running the simulation, we need power GUI block to run it. Otherwise, it will give error. To get this block, just write it in search term of the Simulink library and enter. Copy this block and paste it in your model. Set the simulation time to 1 second. Now you can run the simulation by clicking on this play button. It may be noted that measurement blocks are showing 3 measurements due to the reason that we are measuring all 3 phase voltages and currents. Now you can compare the results with the example results. You can see both results are correct. Now we need to measure the sending end active and reactive power. For this purpose, we need 3-phase power instantaneous block. Take this block from here and bring it in the model. Connect the voltage and current ports of this block with the voltage and current measurement wires. Now connect the display blocks for active and reactive power measurements. To do this, copy this block and paste it here. Connect it here. Similarly, repeat the same procedure to connect this block for reactive power measurement. Change the name of the both display blocks to sending end active and reactive power. Now you can run the simulation again to check these values. You can compare the results with the example results. You can see both results are correct. Now we need to measure the sending end apparent power. For this purpose, we need the product block as well as gain block. Therefore, bring both these blocks from here and bring it in the model. As we know that the apparent power is the product of voltage and current. Therefore, connect the RMS voltage and current measurements with the product block to get the apparent power. Change the name of the product block to S is equal to V into I. Now connect this gain block with this product block. As we need 3-phase sending and apparent power, therefore double click on this gain block and write here 3 and press OK. Now copy this display block, paste it here and connect it with this gain block. Change the name to sending end apparent power. Now you can run the simulation again to check the results. You can compare the results with the example results. You can see both results are correct. Friends, now we need to measure all these parameters at the receiving end side. In order to save the time, just select this whole section, copy it and paste it here at the receiving end side. Now just connect these two wires with the 3-phase measurement block. Now change the names of all these measurements from sending end to receiving end voltage, current, active, reactive and apparent power respectively. Now you can run the simulation again to check the results for the receiving end side. You can compare the results with the example results. You can see all receiving end results are correct. Now we are going to design the model for voltage regulation of the transmission line. We know that the formula for voltage regulation is shown here, which consists of sending end voltage divided by this factor. It may be noted that this factor is only used for long transmission line. For this purpose, we need subtract block and divide block. First, bring both these blocks from here in the model. Bring the divide block here. Connect the first port with the sending end voltage. To divide it with 0.9295, we need a constant block. Therefore, bring the constant block from here in the model. Connect this constant block here. Double click on it. Write 0.9295 here and press OK. Connect the output of this block with the positive terminal of the subtract block. Now connect the negative terminal with the receiving end voltage measurement. Now copy this divide block again. Connect the output of the subtract block with this point and connect the other port with this receiving end voltage. Now copy this gain block, paste it here and connect it with this divide block. Double click on this gain block and write here 100 to get the voltage regulation in percentage. Now copy this display block, paste it here and connect it with this gain block to measure the percentage voltage regulation. Now you can run the simulation again to check the results. You can compare the result with the example results. You can see both results are correct. Now we are going to design the last part of this example that consists of the transmission efficiency. We know that the formula for transmission efficiency is equal to the ratio of the output active power to the input active power. For this purpose, we again need the divide block. Therefore, just copy this divide block, paste it here, connect the first port with the sending end active power, connect the second port with the receiving end active power. Now copy this gain block again, paste it here and connect it with the output of the divide block to convert it into percentage. Similarly, repeat the same procedure to connect the display block here in order to measure the transmission efficiency. Change the name of this block to transmission efficiency. Now you can run the simulation again to check the results. You can compare the results with the example results. You can see both results are correct. Friends, you may wonder that how transmission efficiency can be 100%. The answer to this question is that just look at the example description. It is already mentioned here that transmission line considered in this example is assumed as lossless transmission line. That's why its efficiency is 100%. Friends, that's all for today's tutorial. If you like it, then don't forget to like my video, subscribe my channel and share this with all your friends so that they may also get benefit from this video. Thank you very much.